Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Hilda Crafty, and I'm your friend Hilda. My friend placed an order for a coffee bottle for his cafe. He wanted it very simple and rustic. He really loved it and he wanted to know how I made it. So this video is all about that. I'll be making two bottles, so the other one will be for tea lovers. I asked my friend to send a video. So this is the bottle and that's his beautiful cafe. So let's get started with the video. I'm taking this clear bottle for today's project. You can take a colored, any size, any shape, it's perfectly fine. I use this bottle also. I'll be using this book. As you can see that the pages are yellow and old, which is what I'm looking for in this project. If you don't have an old book, you can even use a book like this. But if you want this look on this type of a paper, then I'll show you how to get this look later in the video. I'm going to tear a few pages, then I'm going to cut the borders. I just want the text. Then I'm going to cut few strips. I have cut few and kept ready. To stick the paper, we will need decoupage glue. For that, we will add 2 parts of any white glue to 1 part of water. That makes it decoupage glue. At the bottom, I'm applying the paper horizontally. Apply the glue and then place the paper. And with the help of a flat brush, press the paper from center to outside so that there are no air bubbles. Using paper cutouts to decorate any object is called decoupage. So we can use any paper for this purpose. Here we are using old storybook pages. Make sure the paper is well stuck at the bottom. Now I plan to place the paper vertically. And next to this, I will place the paper upside down just for some interest. I'll do so all around the bottle. I'll press the brush and also use the back of the brush to make sure that the last vertical strip is well stuck. Now I again plan to use horizontal strips at the top. I have few videos on decoupage. I'll put the link in the description box as well as in the I button above. Now as the bottle will get narrow at the top, I'll use smaller pieces of paper. The interesting part about this project is that you can stop and restart wherever and whenever you wish. Now I'm cutting thin strips as the bottle is getting narrower at the top.
So now I let this dry completely before we go to the next step. This paper, I've turned it into this shade, just like this one, this old book. So I'll show you how to do this.
I'm using Nescafe instant coffee and mixing with normal temperature water. I'll show you on a page. Just take the coffee solution and with the help of a brush, just apply it on the page and let it dry.
Now the paper is dry and you can see this was the paper. And now it's like this, somewhat like this one. And if you feel you wanted more distress, then once it's dry, then again you can put the coffee water. First let it dry and see the look and then apply more. This is after the second coat of coffee water that we applied. So it is more or less like this old paper. This bottle, I'll put the paper horizontally and I'll put the text on one side like this and on the other side like this, just for some interest. And for this top portion, I have used smaller pieces of paper.
Now for this bottle, on the neck, I will use twine. I'll use glue to stick the twine. Now I plan to cover the mouth with a jute fabric. And to stick this, I'll use silicone glue. You can even use hot glue gun. I prefer silicone glue as I always end up having a blister with a hot glue gun. I'll do the same for the other bottle as well.
So now I'll stick some pictures on these bottles with the coffee and tea theme. But you can leave the bottle at this stage just as it is with a little distressing, which I'll do after I stick the pictures. I've taken printout of tea and coffee theme from Google. For this bottle, I'll put coffee images and I can put it on both the sides, this and this. And I think I'll settle for this and this.
After cutting the image, I'll distress the edges to cover the white of the paper so it blends well with the rest of the project. Apply glue and stick on the bottle and then press with a soft cloth so that it sticks very well. Then apply glue over the image. I'll choose this image for the tea bottle. It is very important to apply glue over the image, otherwise we'll have a patchy varnish.
So now I'm going to distress this bottle, and for that we have to keep in mind that we have to distress only the edges because these are the areas which get dirty fast.
Remove the excess ink on a paper and just apply very little at the edges.
Now you can leave it at this stage, but I would like to add a bit of white, just so little bit here and there, just to show that it's a little weathered.
I'm using homemade white gesso. You can click on the I button to watch my video on how to make white gesso at home. All items used for this project are mentioned in the description box below.
Now the bottles are absolutely dry, and for this project I'll surely go for this matte varnish. I plan to put this here, but I think I'll put it here.
This is how the bottles are going to look. These bottles look very good when placed with old books. I have removed the cover and tied a few books with jute twine and put some weeds from my garden. This makes a lovely arrangement. This is all for today. I hope you enjoyed my video. Do like, share, subscribe, and press the notification bell for more such videos. Until then, bye-bye, take care, and I love you all.